guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to be doing a drugstore beauty haul for you guys. And I think that this video is going to be super fun because I've actually never done a beauty haul on my channel before. And in my last video, I had mentioned to you guys that I recently purchased a lot of drugstore makeup and I wanted to know if you guys wanted to see some sort of tutorial. And a lot of you said yes. So I thought, why not show you guys everything that I got that day first before I do a tutorial or anything, because I actually got a lot of stuff that day. I kind of ran out of everything at once, and so I had to purchase a lot of stuff, and then there was also just a lot of neat, cool stuff that I wanted to try that I'd never tried out before, so I just thought I had to have it. So anyways, let's just go ahead and get started, and I'll show you guys everything that I recently got. Oh, and one more thing I want to let you guys know is that I did purchase this stuff probably a couple weeks ago. Some of the stuff I have used already, so I can kind of give you a little review about it. And then there are a few things that I haven't even opened yet, so I don't know if I really like it. So in the future, if you guys would like some sort of review about it, or I can leave some sort of review on my Instagram or something, let me know. Alright, so the first thing that I purchased, I'm actually loving Maybelline lately. Normally, I always gravitate towards L'Oreal for some reason. I don't know why. I think they make a good product, but now I'm sort of gravitating towards Maybelline a lot. I'm really starting to love their products. Now, this is Vivid Matte Liquid Lip Gloss, and I'm actually wearing it today. And when I first put it on, I wasn't sure if I liked it at first, but now I've been wearing it for about a week now, and I really, really like it. I like the way it feels. It's not like completely drying out my lips like a lot of matte lipsticks feel. So I really like this. This is in the color Nude Thrill. I really like this color. It's just a basic everyday color. I feel like it goes with everything. So I'm really, really liking this lately. It's one of the best matte lip glosses I've ever used before. So I would definitely say if you're in the market for a matte lip gloss, definitely try this one out. And I really do like the NYX ones too. Okay, so this next product is also by Maybelline. This is probably my most favorite item that I purchased. Now this is the Fit Me Concealer. I got it in light. This has been a dream. It's been awesome. I'm loving this concealer. Now, normally I use like the L'Oreal True Match concealer, or I use my MAC concealer if I don't want to use a drugstore one. This one is my favorite. It's even passing up my MAC one. This one I've been using every single day since I got it. I'm obsessed with it. The color's great for me. I'm not super, super fair, but the light works perfect for me, so I definitely suggest this. I really would say it's comparable to the NARS concealer. So anyways, if you guys are in the market for a cheap concealer and a really good one, I would say definitely this Maybelline one. Okay, so I guess I'll try to get all my Maybelline stuff out of the way first. So this has been out for a while. I know they have like the nudes, and I think they have like a pink one and maybe a smoky one, I don't know. But this palette reminded me of the Naked palette. I have all the Naked palettes and I love them. I love the consistency of them, and I never really buy drugstore eyeshadows, but I thought I might as well give this a try because I actually really liked all the colors that are in this. I normally just gravitate towards really neutral, natural colors for my eyelids, but I do like some matte, some sparkly, and this has a little bit of both in it, so I thought this might just be perfect for me. So I haven't really tried out this yet. I haven't even opened it, so I definitely can do a little review about this in the future if you guys would like. I don't know, I like the concealer, so hopefully I like their eyeshadow too. Alright guys, so next I'm going to share with you my last Maybelline product, I swear. But anyways, I've been in the market for just a new drugstore foundation. I've been using this L'Oreal one for years and I really like it, but I just kind of wanted to try something new. So I grabbed this Maybelline Dream Velvet Foundation. It's a dream. I mean, this stuff is matte. Yeah, it's called Soft Matte Hydrating Foundation. And I do have a little bit of oily skin, so the fact that this had matte on it, I really, really liked that. Oh my goodness, the consistency of this stuff with a beauty blender is just magnificent. I know you guys can't see what I'm doing. I don't even know why I'm putting this on my hand right now, but it is. It's amazing and I'm obsessing over it. I have it on today and it's just really great. I love the consistency. It works really, really well on my skin. Now, I wouldn't say my skin is like super, super oily. It's kind of normal to oily, and sometimes it is dry. It's very weird. But I got this in the shade 15 Ivory. So I would say these colors run a little bit dark. I mean, I don't know if you guys can see this on my hand. You probably can't see it on my hand. It's blending pretty nicely. I still have to take this back. Oh, here it is. I originally got this in 70, pure beige, just thinking, oh, this will probably work. I didn't want to be that person that, like, opened up every single foundation and tested it at the store, because I just think it's kind of rude. So I grabbed this at first, and let me tell you, 70 was way too dark. Bright orange on my face, didn't blend with my neck at all. So went down to a 15, a whopping 15. So when I got this, I was that person testing them all on my hand. This shade is perfect for me. 70 is bright orange. All right, so next I'm gonna be showing you guys some L'Oreal products that I did pick up. And this gel liner, I've been using this for probably about a year now, and I really, really like it. I get it in the color Espresso. Now, before I started purchasing this, I was getting the MAC Black Track gel eyeliner, and I was using that for years, and I still really, really like that one. But when I ran out of it one time, I went to the drugstore and I ended up getting this L'Oreal one, and let me tell you, like, it's the exact same thing. You really don't have to spend the 10 extra dollars on the MAC one. This L'Oreal one is just as great, and I really didn't want to be wearing black eyeliner anymore. I still wanted something dark, but just not as harsh. So this Espresso color is perfect for me. It's a gel liner, and it actually does come with a little brush, but I don't use the brush that's in it, so, and I never have, so can't even give you a review on that. But I have been using this gel liner for about a year, like I said, and I really, really love it. It lasted me a really long time too. Most gel liners, they dry up really, really fast. Like, I got the Smashbox one from Sephora one time, dried up in within a month. Now this one lasted me quite a long time, and I love it. All right, so the next thing I got was also from L'Oreal, and it was this brow pencil. And recently I switched over to the Anastasia brow pencil that she has, and like the retractable one, and I really, really love it. Before that I was using a pencil by Benefit, and I actually do have a video about that, and I love that one. I used it for a super long time, but I recently switched over to the Anastasia one because I just think it looks a little more natural on me, and I really like it. But it is around $20, and so when I saw this, I looked at it and thought, wow, this looks exactly like the Anastasia one. Now, obviously, I haven't taken out of the package or anything or tested it out at all. I got it in the color Brunette, and I am going to be trying it out. So if you guys want to know anything about this, just let me know, and I will try to get back to you on that. All right, my next L'Oreal product is this Magic Lumi Light Infusing Primer. I've been using this for probably about a year now. I know I did a drugstore video one time and I was using this, so I ran out of it because I was using it so much. I just got another one, and I'm obsessed with this stuff. It really, I'm not wearing it today, but it does just make your skin look super, super glowy. You would not just want to wear it like that and not put foundation over it. You definitely want to put foundation over it, but it is a really, really great primer. You definitely would not think it came from a drugstore at all. So if you guys are looking for a cheap, really good primer, definitely this L'Oreal Magic Lumi one is awesome. All right, and I think this is my last L'Oreal product. I was in the market for a new lotion. Now, I've been using the number 7 products for a really long time. You can get them at Target, and I think you can get them at Ulta too. And anyway, so I've been using their day creams, their night creams, their whole product line for a while, and I really, really like it, but I just kind of wanted to try a different day moisturizer, and this one is a face and neck moisturizer. I don't know why I didn't bring the box in here. It is really, really great. I like it, and I get really paranoid about getting wrinkles at a young age. I just really want to protect my skin, so this one does have an SPF of 18 in it, and then they also have a moisturizer that has an SPF 40 in it. No, SPF 30 in it, and that one looks really good too, but it didn't say face and neck. It just said face moisturizer. Now, I got this one because it said face and neck, and I get really paranoid about wrinkles on my neck. So, yeah, this one has seemed to be great so far. It was under $20 and is working really well. So I like that. All right guys, so the next beauty products I'm gonna be talking about are the Milani products. And I've actually never used any of the Milani products. I've seen a lot of girls on YouTube using it and I always thought it was really cool. I didn't know it was a drugstore product though. So I've never used it, and then I went to my drugstore and they had it, and I think it was new because I'd never seen it there before. So the first thing I picked up, and I've been wearing it every single day since I got it, was the Milani Baked Blush. And I got this because I've heard a lot of people talk about it, and even the packaging is just beautiful, like with the gold, and it looks like this. It's baked, and then it does come with a little brush, but I probably wouldn't use this. I don't know how well that would get it on, but it has a little mirror on it. And then this is in the color Dolce Pink. So I'm loving this. I have it on today. I've been wearing it probably every day for the past week, week and a half. And yeah, I would definitely suggest these blushes if you're in the market for a blush. They have lots of different colors, but I really like this one, Dolce Pink. So, since I love the blush so much, I actually haven't tried this yet because I am working on kind of getting rid of the rest of my other bronzer that I'm using right now. But this is the Milani All Over Glow Bronzer, and it's huge. So, I bet it would take a really long time to get through this, but it's called Fake Tan, and it's in the number 2. So, I'm going to try this out, but I have no idea even what to say about this because I've never used their bronzers, but I've had a lot of good luck with the blush, so I'm guessing that the bronzer is really good too. Alright guys, so the last Milani product that I want to show you is this new mascara that I purchased, and I'm really excited about it because I noticed the brush looks really different and cool. I've never seen a brush like this. It actually gets longer on the tip, and it says, bristles on tip, catch hard to reach lashes. And I always have a really hard time kind of getting these little lashes on the inside. So anyways, I guess we will see how that goes. Obviously haven't used it, but I got it in the color black. 108. So I will try to let you guys know what I think of this mascara after I use it. I've got a good feeling about it. Okay, and just a few non-related makeup stuff, but still beauty items that I purchased were these Bior Deep Cleansing Charcoal Pore Strips. And I did buy these probably a few months back, and I loved them. They were amazing. And I get like the worst blackheads on my nose. I know that's disgusting, but I haven't used these in quite a few months. And I was looking at my nose the other day, and I was like, holy moly, we gotta do something about that because my pores were like black on my nose. So these things are amazing. I would suggest them to anybody who has blackheads on their nose. Now they have just like the regular Biore pore strips, but these charcoal ones, I think they're a million times better, but they are for more oily skin, like what I said I have. So it says, see 3 times less oil. So I like that. Alright, and I cracked into these bad boys pretty fast. I always get the Neutrogena makeup remover pads. I always use them before or after I wash my face just to kind of get any leftover stuff that my face wash didn't get. So I always use these, and I really like them. I think I saw that Kim Kardashian uses them too. So, I mean, that must mean they're good, right? But I've always gotten these. They get the job done. Alright, and the last thing that I purchased were these little eyebrow shapers. Do I use them as eyebrow shapers? No. It actually says you can use them on your face, neck, arms, and bikini area. I always get these little shavers for my face. I do shave off any peach fuzz on my face, or if I get any like on my neck or anything. I just think it makes a much cleaner look. So you can use this on your lip, all over your face. If you are not a hairy woman like me, then you wouldn't need these. But I am a hairy woman, and yeah, I shave my face and I'm proud of it. So anyways, this is Persona brand. I just got these at the drugstore, and I don't always find them there. These are actually really hard to find. I know you can order these online. There's tons of different brands of little face shavers you can get. And I've never had a problem with like my hair growing back thicker or turning into like a manly beard or anything. So just thought I'd throw that out there. That was everything that I got for this beauty haul. So I really hope that you guys liked it. I thought it was super fun to just show you guys everything that I recently got. So if you guys would still like to see that makeup tutorial and then I can kind of give you a review of some of these products, please let me know in the comments below. So thank you guys so much for watching. If you are new to my channel, please don't forget to subscribe. And also please give this video a thumbs up if you liked it. So again, thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you very soon in the next video.